So let's talk a little bit about petroleum or oil. Basically, wanted to kind of start out with where do we get oil? So basically, oil started out in shallow oceans, and it's important to note shallow oceans because a lot of people think that it's the dinosaurs and things like that. And I suppose some of the oil may have come from that, but the majority of oil comes from these formations back in when the continents were all together. 350, 400 million years ago, there were these shallow oceans. And what happened was the algae and plankton and things like that die and they go to the bottom. And that's biomass, basically. And that goes to the bottom. And over time, sand and silt and things like that build up on top of it. So it's kind of like I describe it kind of like an oil sandwich. So basically, you've got this confining layer, this sort of bedrock below. Which holds the what will become oil, which is biomass for the time being, into this sort of bowl. And the reason for a shallow ocean being so important is because if oxygen can get to the biomass, then it will have degraded it a long time ago. Just like when a tree falls in the woods today, it doesn't turn into oil. It basically gets consumed by fungi and bacteria and bugs and things like that that are gonna basically break it down and consume it. And that's because there's availability of oxygen. Well, in shallow oceans, what happened was it's oxygen starved, and so these things sort of built up over time, and they weren't degraded. So it's held in this bowl, and then sand and silt build up on top of that, and then sort of another confining layer up above caps it off, and then it has to go through a very specific process where it goes down about anywhere from 10,000 to 16,000 feet or so. And we really don't find oil much past that because it gets too close to the Earth's magma, and it's heated up too much in it, and it's destroyed. It's mineralized, so you can't dig deeper to find more oil. It's one of the myths out there. And then the other aspect is it's got to go all the way that deep, which has to undergo. It requires a tremendous amount of time in order to do that. So it starts out up near the surface. And then it goes through Earth geologic process, and the tectonic plates start subducting, and basically you get the crushing pressure of the Earth up above, a couple of miles of Earth up above. And what that does is that creates a very specific set of circumstances where pressure and temperature are just right to basically sort of cook the biomass and turn it into oil or natural gas. Basically, natural gas and oil are found in a lot of similar places because the same conditions are required to exist for both. Coal is slightly different, but by and large similar.